Would you believe that no school rules are better than school rules or classroom rules? When you understand the difference between classroom rules and procedures, you will understand why my five simple classroom rules are so effective. You will also understand the reason that my basic school rules are essentially school rules in real life. Since the rules of the classroom are to promote responsibilities, why not use a more effective term than classroom rules, such as responsibilities? Understand that basic school rules are counterproductive and prompt stress between adults and the young people. This is because rules place the adult in an adversarial relationship. Relying on rules is coercive and promotes obedience rather than responsibility. When I returned to classroom teaching after 24 years in a variety of administrative positions, including service as an elementary, middle, and high school principal, as well as a director of education, I quickly discovered how rules hindered good relationships and effective discipline. I found myself coming to school every day wearing a blue uniform with copper buttons. I had become a cop enforcing rules rather than a facilitator of learning, a role model, a mentor, and a coach. The reason is simple. If a student breaks a rule, our tendency is to enforce the rule. This is a natural thought process because the assumption is that if the rule is not enforced, others will take advantage of it. Therefore, in order to maintain control, goes the thinking, if a rule is broken, it must be enforced. Now, rules are essential in games, but in relationships between people, reliance on rules is counterproductive because the enforcement mentality automatically creates adversarial relationships. Enforcing rules often promotes power struggles that rarely result in win-win situations. Rules aim at obedience, but obedience does not inspire, nor do rules create desire. In addition, rules aim at compliance, and if a rule is not followed, compliance itself is often followed by some coercive actions such as threats and imposed punishments. Although the establishment of rules is motivated by good intentions, their implementation often produces deleterious effects. When Johns Hopkins University researchers analyzed data from more than 600 schools, they found 7 characteristics associated with student discipline problems. 4 of them concerned rules. 1. Rules were unclear or perceived as unfairly or inconsistently enforced. 2. Students didn't believe in the rules. 3. Teachers and administrators disagreed on the proper responses to student misconduct. 4. Teachers tended to have punitive attitudes. This last finding, that teachers tended to have punitive attitudes, is often the result of an enforcement mindset of relying on rules. Note that people don't buy from someone they don't like, and this includes relationships with young people. Even the slowest salesperson knows enough not to alienate their prospective customer. A prime purpose of teachers is to market information. Again, some people don't buy from people they don't like. Rules are left hemisphere dominant. They are sensible, orderly, and structured. Left hemisphere dominant students are often the ones who follow rules and are successful in school. But what about the right hemisphere dominant types of student who acts spontaneously and impulsively and whose brain processes randomly? These are the students who don't follow the rules. These students need structure, and relying on rules does not provide what these students need for success. After analyzing my rules, I concluded that they were actually expectations or procedures. Realizing that positivity is more effective than negativity, having a desire to empower rather than to overpower my students, and wanting to promote responsibility, I stopped using the term rules. Since my goal was to promote responsibility, I use the following responsibilities: have my materials, be where I belong, follow directions, do my assignments, and be kind to others. Notice that there are only 5 expectations and all are positive. When a student does not follow a procedure, the natural tendency is to teach the procedure until it is learned. This is positive and empowering, and the same approach teachers use for anything else that is taught. It's called checking for understanding. The procedure reinforces what is taught. There is no coercion involved. I found that teaching procedures is the essence of good classroom management. Here is what I did. Regardless of the grade level I taught, I did not assume students knew what I wanted them to do. Instead, I modeled the procedure, taught it, and the class practiced it. In addition, every time my students did something that bothered me, I asked myself, what procedure can I teach? Since the brain envisions images rather than words, I started to have my students visualize procedures. For example, the number of homework assignments that I received significantly increased when I started having my students visualize procedures about doing their homework. I started asking questions such as the following: when will you do your homework? If you are engaged in some enjoyable activity, what procedure will you use to redirect your attention in order to do your homework? Where will you do your homework? Sitting at a table or lying on your bed? Will you be watching television and have your brain switch tasking? What materials will you need to take home or have ready to accomplish the task? When I started teaching procedures, rather than relying on rules, my relationship significantly increased, as did my students' learning. In addition, I had no discipline problems, and I truly gained the joy that classroom teaching has to offer. My race responsibility system is now used around the world. Check it out at withoutstress.com under the teachers link in the menu bar. So here's a tip. Change your mindset from one of enforcing rules to teaching procedures. You will find yourself improved relationships and truly gain the joy of classroom teaching. Just remember that kids don't care what you know until they know you care.